السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويل لكل همزة لمزة الذي جمع مالا وعدده، يحسب أن ماله أخلده، كلا لينبذن في الحطمة. وما أدراك ما الحطمة؟ نار الله الموقدة، التي تطلع على الأفئدة، إنها عليهم مؤصدة، في عمد ممددة. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. O children of Adam, first and foremost I enjoin upon myself and then all of you all who have come here to adopt a life of taqwa. For it is only through the cultivation of taqwa can we hope to attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah the Almighty make us all from the people of taqwa. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in today's khutbah, I intend to, inshaAllah ta'ala, give you all a fleeting glimpse of the blazing fire of Jahannam and its punishment. I do not intend to terrify you or frighten you in any way, but rather I am adopting the methodology found in the noble Quran, the speech of our beloved maker Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The methodology which is at-targhib and at-tarhib. At-targhib and at-tarhib. At-targhib is to incite a person, to encourage a person towards goodness, towards something good. Likewise, at-tarhib is to fill a person's heart with terror over something, to fill a person's heart with fear over something. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the noble Quran. حَامِيم تَنزِيلُ الْكِتَابِ مِنَ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ غَافِرِ الذَّنْبِ وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ شَدِيدِ الْعِقَابِ ذِي التَّوْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. Look at the balance, Allahu Akbar. تَنزِيلُ الْكِتَابِ مِنَ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. It is indeed a revelation, the revelation of the noble Quran, مِنَ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. غَافِرِ الذَّنْبِ وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ. Indeed, he is the one who forgives sins, وَقَابِلِ التَّوْبِ, and he accepts our repentance. But on the other hand, شديد العقاب ذي الثول. Allah the Almighty, He is most forgiving. But likewise, شديد العقاب, the most painful punishments are inflicted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is indeed severe in His punishments. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another place, Allah the Almighty, He says, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inform, نَبِّعْ عِبَادِي, inform my slaves, أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, I am the most forgiving, the most merciful. وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. And indeed my punishment, أَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْعَلِيمُ. My punishment, it is a painful torment. It is a painful punishment. Look at the balance. Allah the Almighty, He is using targhib and then tarheeb. Allah the Almighty is striking a balance between al-raja and al-khawf. Between hope and fear. Because at the end of the day, it is in accordance with the statement of my beloved Shaykh Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. He says, Al-qalbu fi sayrihi ila Allah azza wa jal bi manzilati at-ta'ir. A believer's heart, on its journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a believer's heart on its journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like a bird. فَالْمَحَبَّ رَأْسُهُ. Love is its head, the head of the bird. Love in the sense, love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and naturally love for our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالْخَوْفُ وَالْرَجَاءُ جَنَاحًا. Fear and hope are the two wings of this bird. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, no matter what the bird may be, it may be an eagle that soars above the skies, but my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, if one of its wings were to be damaged, that bird cannot fly. Inevitably, it is going to come crashing down and it is going to damage its other wing too. A bird needs two wings to soar beautifully, to fly perfectly. Likewise, the heart of a believer. A believer needs these two wings to fly to his beloved maker, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need the balance between al-raja and al-khawf. We need the balance between hope and fear. We have to have hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to have hope that Allah the Almighty will forgive all of our sins. Likewise, we need to fear the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to fear the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So based on this methodology, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, I intend to base today's khutbah on a brief description of Jahannam. We start off, let me take you all on this description. We start off from the Sirat. Now what is Sirat? What is this Sirat? Sirat, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is a bridge. It is a bridge laid over Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. It is a bridge laid over Jahannam. There is no time to go into the horrors of the Day of Judgment. And one of the reasons why I brought this topic about, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is that because we have become so deceived by dunya, we run behind dunya, we hanker behind dunya, and there are even some of us who now even doubt the inevitable fact of death. There are some of us who doubt that we will be resurrected after death. Some of us doubt that there will be resurrection, there will be questioning by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is something known as Jannah, something known as paradise, and something known as Jahannam, hell. Allahu Akbar. Indeed, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, there is the life in the qabr. There is the questioning by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is the day of judgment. There is the mahshar. There is the ardul mahshar. And afterwards, there is the sirat, the bridge that has been laid across Jahannam. Allah the Almighty, He says in the Noble Quran, وَإِن مِّنكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا. It is inevitable. وَإِن مِّنكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا. There is none of you except that you'll have to cross that bridge. You have to cross over Jahannam. كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا. This is upon your Lord an inevitability that has been decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to cross Jahannam, upon the Sirat, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Now, summing up a few ahadith of our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that describe Sirat, let me briefly describe it to you. Primarily, number one, the Sirat, the bridge, it will be laid across Jahannam. It will be laid across Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. It will be finer. It will be thinner than a hair. It will be finer than a hair. Thinner than a hair. So fine. So thin. It will be sharper than a sword. Allahu Akbar. It will be sharper than a sword. It will be extremely steep and very, very slippery. Anybody who tries to cross it will indeed slip, except for the ones Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed otherwise. It is an indeed slippery, steep bridge. It will be extremely dark, as it is going to be over Jahannam. Now don't picture Jahannam to be a bright, flamy place, but rather, hadith is in Tirmidhi, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Allah the Almighty, the hadith goes along the lines of these words, Allah the Almighty lit the fire of Jahannam for 1,000 years. For 1,000 years the fire was kindled. This must make shivers run down our spine. Goosebumps come across our skin, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. The fear of Allah must fill our hearts. The fire of Jahannam was kindled for 1,000 years. Until it became a bright red. And then afterwards it was kindled for 1,000 years. Until it became sparkling white. And then onwards it was kindled for 1,000 years. Until it became pitch black. Currently that is the state of Jahannam. Pitch black. The flames are pitch black. Just imagine a bridge over Jahannam which is pitch black. That bridge is also going to be dark as ever. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. And we have to cross this bridge, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. The bridge will be full of hooks and thorns. Hooks and thorns which would come across the people who are crossing, trying to snag them according to their sins. For each and every lie we utter, a hook or a thorn would try to snag us and pull us down to make us go plummeting into Jahannam. For every haram gaze that we cast whilst we are walking on the street, the hooks and thorns will try to catch us. For every interest transaction that we place our signatures upon, whether it be whether we are on the receiving end, giving end or witness, these hooks, these thorns would try to snag us. May Allah the Almighty save us all. Allahumma sallim sallim. Allahumma sallim sallim. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the people who are crossing this bridge would keep hearing horrifying screams. Allahu Akbar. Each sinner who slips on this bridge and goes crashing into Jahannam would scream. These screams would be the background noise of the people who are trying to cross this bridge. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Now in regard to the people who cross this bridge, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said along the lines of these words, some of them would cross in the twinkling of an eye. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from those who cross the Sirat in the twinkling of an eye. They will be the people of taqwa. They will be the awliyaullah, the friends of Allah. They will be the ones who adopted our master's life as their life. They will be the ones who their hearts are full of pure love for Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They would cross the Sirat in the twinkling of an eye. Then there would be some who would cross at the speed of lightning. Then there would be some who would cross at the speed of the wind. Then there would be some who would cross like the speed of the birds. Then there would be some who would cross at the speed of race horses. Then there would be some who would go crawling, who the thorns would snag them, but they would drag themselves and make it over to the other corner. At least they would be saved. But then there would be a group, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, of sinners who will be involved, who are currently involved in vice, transgressions, crimes. They would try to cross the Sirat, failing to do so, they would plummet down into the pitch black flames of Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from that group. Allahu Akbar. Moving on to Jahannam. In regard to the depth of Jahannam, hadith is in Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates, once they were all seated with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, suddenly they heard a crashing sound. They heard a crashing sound. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'een, Ataduruna ma hada? Do you all know what that sound is? Qulna, they replied, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. They replied that Allah and His Messenger know best. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم replies that it was a rock thrown into Jahannam which has been falling, which has been plummeting for the past 70 years, and finally it has reached the bottom of Jahannam, and that is the crash you'll hear along the lines of these words. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. 70 years, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. This is in regard to the depth of Jahannam. In regard to the depth of Jahannam. The surah I recited in the beginning, Allah the Almighty, He says in the Noble Quran, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. Woe be unto every scorner, every mocker, the one who makes a mockery of the deen. Woe be unto him. Woe be unto all of them. الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ. The ones who collect money stingily and counting their money. The ones who waste the life of this dunya, hankering behind this dunya, amassing millions, not bothering whether the source is halal or haram. Stingily counting every single penny. يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. He thinks that that wealth will give him immortality, that he will be able to escape death. كَلَّا لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُتَمَةِ. Nay, rather he will be flung into the حُتَمَةِ. He will be flung into the crusher. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْحُتَمَةِ. And what will make you perceive, or what will make you understand what that crusher is? نَارُ اللَّهِ الْمُوْقَدَةِ. It is the fire of Allah which has been kindled eternally. الَّتِي تَطَّلِعُ عَلَى الْأَفْئِدَةِ. It will mount directly at the hearts of those individuals. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the blazing fire of Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, يُؤْتَى بِالنَّارِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. On the day of judgment. On the day of judgment, one of the horrors of the day of judgment is that Jahannam, the fire of Jahannam will be brought to the Ardul Mahshar. Jahannam will be brought on the day of Qiyamah. لَهَا سَبْعُونَ أَلْفْ زِمَامٍ. Jahannam will have 70,000 bridles. You know bridles that you pull a horse with? 70,000 bridles for Jahannam. And each bridle will be pulled by 70,000 angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Each bridle will be pulled by 70,000 malaika, totaling 4.9 billion malaika will be dragging Jahannam. And Jahannam will be roaring. Jahannam will be in a fury. Jahannam will be, the fire would be crackling and roaring due to the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. May Allah the Almighty save us all from the blazing fire of Jahannam. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in regard to the fire of Jahannam, we already discussed, or we already mentioned, that it is pitch black. Pitch black, as it has been kindled for 3,000 years. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said along the lines of these words, نَارُكُمْ هَذِهِ مَا يُوْقَدُ بَنُوا آدَمْ. O children of Adam, the fire that you kindle, or the fire that you have today with you, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, can we even think of touching the flame of a candle? Can we even think of keeping our fingers by a tiny candle? Look at the hadith of our master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The fire that you, O children of Adam, kindle is what? جُزْءٌ وَاحِدٌ مِّن سَبْعِينَ جُزْءًا مِّن نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. It is just 1/70th. It is just 1/70th of the fire of Jahannam. The fire that we see in this dunya, the fire that we are accustomed to, the fire that we are terrified of, leave alone a candle. Just imagine a petrol bunker bursting in flames. Can we imagine that scene? How terrified are we of forest fires? Look at the flames, all of that included. All of the fire in dunya, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is just 1/70th when you keep it with the fire of Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the blazing fire of Jahannam. The least punishment an individual would face in Jahannam, the person who would give the least punishment. Hadith is in Bukhari, Muslim, authentic hadith. I'm not bringing things from my pocket. I'm not concocting tales to keep you all entertained. All of these are ahadith from the highest books of authenticity in terms of ahadith, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. From the words of our Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. He does not speak out of his own desires. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. It is all divine revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadith is in Bukhari, Muslim. The person who would face the least punishment in Jahannam is that he would have to wear a pair of shoes made of blazing fire of Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. And due to the heat of those two shoes, his brain would literally begin to boil. It would begin to boil. His brain would melt and begin to boil. And at that point, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, he would consider himself as the person who is being afflicted the greatest punishment of Jahannam, whilst in reality he would be the person who has been afflicted with the least severe punishment of Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Moving on to the food that will be served to the denizens of the hellfire. Moving on to the food that will be served to the inhabitants of Jahannam. What will be the food that will be served to them, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? They will be served al-zaqoom. They will be served ghislin. What is al-zaqoom? Allah the Almighty says in the noble Quran, لَآكِنُونَ مِن شَجَرٍ مِن زَقُومٍ فَمَانِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ فَشَارِبُونَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْحَمِيمِ فَشَارِبُونَ شُرْبَ الْهِيمِ هَذَا نُزُلُهُمْ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ نَحْنُ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَآكِلُونَ مِن شَجَرٍ مِن زَقُومٍ. They will eat from the tree which is known as الزقوم. From the tree of زقوم. فَمَالِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ. They will fill their tummies, their bellies with it. فَشَارِبُونَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْحَمِيمِ. And over that, hameem will be poured. Scalding hot water will be poured over what they have eaten. فَشَارِبُونَ شُرْبَ الْهِيمِ. They will be so thirsty, they will drink like thirsty camels. هَذَا نُزُلُهُمْ يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. This will be your accommodation, O denizens of Jahannam, on the day of Qiyamah. نَحْنُ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ. We created you all. فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ. And why could you all not? فَلَوْلَا, you should have or perhaps confirmed or believed in it. Allahu Akbar. Now what is الزقوم? What is الزقوم? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place, إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةٌ تَخْرُجُ فِي أَصْلِ الْجَحِيمِ طَلْعُهَا كَأَنَّهُ رُؤُسُ الشَّيَاطِينِ. الزقوم is a tree. Its roots will be from the bottom part of Jahannam. It will root out or come out from the lowest part of Jahannam. إِنَّهَا شَجَرَةٌ تَخْرُجُ فِي أَصْلِ الْجَحِيمِ
طلعها كأنه رؤوس الشياطين. Its branches will be like the heads of the devils. Allahu Akbar. This will be the food, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, served to the denizens of Jahannam. It will be thorny. It will be poisonous. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that even if a drop of this tree as zakum is put on this dunya, not one plant would grow on the face of this earth. It is so poisonous. Just imagine having to fill your bellies, having to fill your tummies with such a poisonous plant, with such a poisonous tree. That is the only food the denizens of Jahannam would get. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from Jahannam. In regard to ghislin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ
And as for the person who will be given his book of records on his left hand, Allahu Akbar, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. He has lost whatever the problems, whatever the afflictions you face in dunya, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, temporary, 60, 70 years and you're done with it. But if you lose in akhirah, if you lose by Allah, you are going to eternally abide in Jahannam. Allah save us all.
وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالٍ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَاً.
He said, woe be unto me. Woe be unto me. Had it been that I have not got this book at all,
مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيًا.
What benefit has my wealth availed me today? How has my wealth, all of the millions that I have, all of the houses that I own, all of the cars that I own, how is it going to benefit me on this day?
هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيًا.
My power, my authority, everything has been destroyed. Nothing is there to save me on this day. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, ponder on the words of your beloved Maker. Reflect, bring in the fear of Allah, the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To this individual it will be said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command,
خُذُوهُ فَغُلُّونَ ثُمَّ الْجَحِيمَ صَلُّونَ ثُمَّ فِي سِلْسِلَةٍ ذَرْعُهَا 70 ذِرَاعًا فَاسْلُكُونَ.
He will be tied up with chain, 70 cubits length. In chain he will be tied up and he will be flung into the fire of Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. The reason being, لا يؤمن بالله العظيم. He did not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا يحض على طعام المسكين. Nor did he encourage in spending for the poor. He was stingy. He wanted to only amass dunya. فليس له اليوم هاهنا حميم. حميم. On that day, there will be no companion for him.
وَلَا تُعَامٌ إِلَّا مِنْ غِسْلِينَ.
And on that day there will be no food, no beverage other than غِسْلِينَ. What is غِسْلِينَ? غِسْلِينَ is the discharge from one's wounds. Allahu Akbar. Pus, a pus mixture of a drink made up of pus and blood and filth and discharge of wounds. This will be the beverage that will be given to him. Scalding hot water, the fruit of the tree as zakum. These are the things that will be served to the denizens of Jahannam. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the food of Jahannam will be fire. The drink of Jahannam will be fire. The clothes of Jahannam will be fire. Everything will be boiling. Everything will be scalding. Everything will be ablaze. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Finally, I leave you all with a hadith which discusses about a ghamsa, about one dip in Jahannam. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrates, hadith is in Muslim. On the day of judgment, yu'ta bi an'ami ahli dunya min ahli nar. The person, the most richest person in dunya, The person who enjoys the most amount of luxuries. The one who is blessed, privileged in dunya. He will be from the people of Jahannam. He will be brought on the day of Qiyamah. This man will be brought فَيُسْبَغُ فِي النَّارِ صِبَغًا. And what will happen? This man will be brought, hadith goes along the lines of these words. He will be brought and he will be dipped into Jahannam. Or else, Jahannam would barely touch him. He would be dipped into Jahannam. And then it will be asked from him, يَبْنَ آدَمْ يَبْنَ آدَمْ هَلْ رَأَيْتَ خَيْرًا قَدْ هَلْ مَرَّ بِكَ نَعِيمٌ قَدْ. Oh, son of Adam, after the dipping into Jahannam, it will be asked by him, O son of Adam, have you ever enjoyed anything in dunya? Have you ever enjoyed any luxury in dunya? Were you happy in dunya? And you know what he would say, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? He would say, La wallahi ya Rab. No, I have never enjoyed anything. Allahu Akbar. We slave behind dunya. We run behind dunya. Just one dip into Jahannam makes him forget every single thing of dunya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from being fooled by this dunya. Hadith goes on. Now another man will be brought forward. This man will be the man who suffered the most in dunya. He faced all kinds of trials, all kinds of calamities, all kinds of tribulations. The person who suffered the most. And you know what? He will be from the people of Jannah. Allahu Akbar. The most richest person, we saw the hadith highlighting that he will be from the people of Jahannam. But as for the person who suffered the most, he will be from the people of Jannah. O children of Adam, if you are going through trials, if you are going through afflictions, if you are going through calamities, glad tidings be unto you. You are indeed from the people of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannah. This man will be brought, the man who faced so much of difficulties in dunya, he will be dipped once into Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Just one dip into paradise. He will be dipped into Jannah. And he will be taken out and it will be asked by him, Yabna Adam, Yabna Adam, Hal Ra'aita Bu'san Qat, Hal Marra Bika Min Shiddatin Qat. Did you ever face any difficulty in your life? Did you face any misfortune, any calamity in your life? And you know what that man will say? La Wallahi Ya Rab, La Wallahi Ya Rab, Ma Ra'aitu Bu'san, Wala Marra Bi Min Shiddatin Qat. Allahu Akbar. Just one dip into Jannah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. And he forgets all of the problems, all of the afflictions, all of the calamities of this dunya. That highlights, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that the life of this dunya is indeed temporary. Temporary. Nothing to worry about. Because our abode is al-akhirah. We are headed there. We are on a journey. This is just a transitory station that we are stopping by. There's nothing to worry us. Because at the end of the day, the eternal bliss that we will be blessed in Jannah is so eternal, is so blissful, that all of these problems of dunya, we would just forget it. All of these sicknesses, trials, calamities, everything would seem insignificant. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the fire of Jahannam. And may Allah the Almighty bless us to enter Jannah. May He unite all of us in the gardens of Jannah. May He forgive all of our sins and may He accept all of our good deeds. May Allah the Almighty bless all of our wealth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the best in this world and the hereafter. And may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.